Anything below these belts, I will warn you twice, third time, or take a point away.
I'm still looking to kill the spin.
Obey my command, shake hands, good luck.
All right, Seldon's relaxed. The excitement mounts. The goosebumps are up. The hair standing up on the neck of the two fighters. We're set to go. This is for the heavyweight championship of the world. Nothing more exciting in the world of sports than this. Here we go. Bruce Seldon, look at him. Full of confidence. Can he hold him off with that jab? Will his right hand be there? Will his chin be sturdy enough? That's what we'll find out. Look at this guy. Total determination. No change of expression. Richard Steele, a veteran. 137 fights in there. Bruce Seldon tries to keep him off. Mike will pressure him early. Seldon will try to keep him off with that jab. And he's already clipped him with a left hook, and Seldon stumbled into the ropes. Seldon trying to pump that jab in the face and stay away from Mike Tyson here in the early going. Seldon, of course, in the white Mike Tyson in the black trunks comes right after him. There's Seldon trying to tie him up inside, and he does as Richard Steele has to separate him. You get the idea that Tyson has absolutely no fear, and that Seldon is a little bit more concerned than he was a few moments ago. The over and under for the betting public is four rounds, so they expect Tyson to win. But Bruce Seldon says, I can hold him off and I'm throwing more right hands. That remains to be seen. That's what it's all about. Will Mike continue to move back and forth, bob and weave, get set up to land the shot? Bruce pumps that big jab in the face. He's got the reach advantage. He doesn't want to get caught in here. And what he does, he ties him up. And that's the way he's going to fight this guy. He can't allow that distance, that no man's land inside. He can't give that distance to Mike, because if Mike can get inside and nail him, he's going to hurt him. Mike continues to try and push him. Bruce throws and then hangs on. Tyson all business now. He has the confidence. He knows that he can hurt him in a shot. And Bruce was down. I didn't actually see what if he was hit. But Richard Steele waves it off. And Bruce a little bit wobbly. I don't know whether he can hit in the body or just what happened there. Richard Steele now gives him the standing eight count. At first, he waved it off as if he was going to call it a slip. And then Bruce stayed down. And it will be scored as a knockdown. Tyson touches him again, and Bruce gets down. He's hit with a left hook. The count's up to two and three. I don't know if Bruce can recover from that shot. He's back up on his legs. He seems okay. He's been down twice in this round. Hey, what's going to happen here? No, it's all over. His legs are gone. His legs are gone. And it's a first round TKO for Mike Tyson. Again, Bruce Seldon's legs were totally gone. He got clipped. I thought it was a slip the first time. And Bruce Seldon was hurt by the second shot and could not recover. He got back up, and now Tyson is talking to him. And all week long, Bruce has thanked him, but it didn't turn out to be much of a fight. And if he's the best opponent around, what lies in store for the other opponents of Mike Tyson? Well, with all the buildup, it came at 1:49 in the first round. And Tyson just is the baddest man in the world. $15 million. That's $5 million for every about 30 seconds he talks. Well, it just shows the superiority of Mike Tyson and the punching power. The question was answered about the jaw of Bruce Seldon. And I feel kind of bad for Bruce, because he's such a nice guy and had such high hopes. But this guy right here is the man. Mike Tyson, totally determined. All the work, 5-6 months of training, and he can't stand up, and the crowd is kind of in shock. He just couldn't stand up to him. He got hit with what looked like a body shot, and I'm sure we'll see it from several different angles so we find out what happened to that first man who went down. Richard Steele, the referee, was ready to call it a slip, and then he didn't get right back up, so he gave him a standing eight count, and then Tyson came in and finished him off. It looked like a left hook. They caught him, and down he went, and it was all over. So all the questions about the chin have been answered. Bruce did not stand up to the tremendous shot that Mike Tyson was able to land. The first time he got hit, that was it. Let's see the first knockdown. A very disappointing night for this guy. He didn't have the fear, but he didn't have the strength of chin. And he couldn't have got himself in better shape for this fight. Mike Tyson is a superior warrior. That's all there is to it. Let's watch this first knockdown and see what we can see. It happened right above me, and I couldn't tell. I thought it was just a slip, as Richard did.
No.
I don't see any punch there. It just sort of falls down, and Richard calls it a slip like a push down. And Bruce kind of stays down. I don't know exactly what happened there. I'm sure Dr. Pacheco will ask him about that.
Hey, go ahead, Bruce.
Same punch, and again, he never really is hit. He just goes down. It looked like he hit him a little bit with a forearm, is all I could pick up there. And we'll show you. Let's see if we can see that forearm. If it catches him any place, it shakes him. No, instead, we're going to show you the end of the fight. May, he is, in fact, hit with a left hook there, and the legs just go right from underneath him, and that's all she wrote. And he definitely was hurt, because when he got up, his legs were totally gone. You see Richard continue the counters up to 4 and 5 there. Look at, see, he falls back, and his legs are rubbery. Richard continues to get the 8 count. He looks into his eyes, and he's ready to come out. He tries to shake it off, but look at the legs. Look at this. He falls back. I mean, there's no question that he's hurt, and that's all Richard can do. I mean, he says, are you okay? He goes to step, and his legs aren't there. The man's knocked out on his feet. So the left hook did hurt him.
Well, I think a lot of people...
We're getting ready to go into the ring for the interviews, and I think I see Jim Gray in there. We'll have the announcement from Jimmy Lennon Jr. first. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a